Hi everyone, another email, another video explainer. Just find this way is a lot easier to try and get some points across that might be lost in translation in the text of an email. So yeah, we're getting a lot closer to reopening the facility, which is brilliant. 25th of July on the Saturday, so we're really looking forward to that, and we are making our preparations. We've got a few points to clear up before we go ahead, and some key changes to what we're doing here at Method Training. So first point that was in the email is our class offering. So there's a couple of things that go with this. When we made the decision to change to Method, CrossFit was already in my opinion, in a bit of a shaky place. It was making some very tough decisions, some decisions that I found tough to stand by. And then I thought that at that time, it was only really a matter of time before there was some kind of implosion, and that did happen very publicly with Greg Glassman's comments. But what I didn't expect to happen was the outcome of that. So instead of CrossFit further imploding, it's actually been taken over by a really enthusiastic and exciting and very, by all accounts, a really good guy in Eric Rosa. So we're looking forward to seeing what happens there. And we feel now that this is a really good time to be making maybe a tentative step back towards being more involved with CrossFit. So in summary, the classes that you will attend when you come back to Method Training are going to be CrossFit classes. Okay, so that's going to combine the best bits of Kilo and Kinetic. So when we changed, we broke the strength and the conditioning sections apart, and now we're going to put them back together. So classes are either going to have a strength portion at the start, followed by a conditioning piece, or they're going to be skewed in the favor of either one, depending on what day of the week it is, to make sure we're constantly varying the workouts. So yeah, CrossFit classes to start with. We are much happier with the direction of the CrossFit Inc. company now. The second change, this applies to the members that have been with us for a long time and who have been with us before the changeover to Method, part of the CrossFit Northumbria brand. We are gonna change the membership structure to a non-unlimited package. We have gone from 32 class spaces per hour to 16 class spaces per hour. We've gone from running two classes at once to just running one session. We have to make sure that there's no sharing of kit, that we've got a minimum requirement for space per person, so we can't give that unlimited membership anymore. It doesn't work. If we give unlimited sessions and booking, we couldn't effectively serve everyone in the membership fairly. So what we are doing is moving anyone who is on the unlimited to a 24 membership pack, and that renews every month, 24 credits. That is roughly it's about 6 per week. So you can still get a lot of sessions in. 24 session. If you book your sessions carefully, you attend your classes and you do 6 per week, there's really going to be zero change for you in this new format if you follow it like that. So we think that this is the best way moving forward to create a fair system to make sure that people get good use of each class space available now that they have been, they're not as plentiful as they were in the old system. Next point is that all classes will be capped at 16. This is as per government and trade body restrictions. So we need to provide at least a 3 meter by 3 meter square area for each person to train. In the facility that we've got now, we've got an extension for the rig, and we've got all the racks behind, so we can have 16 individualized places where everyone can have their barbell, they can have a pull-up bar, they can have a wall ball target, they can have essentially just a... We didn't want to sacrifice the quality of the session just because of these restrictions. So everyone's got hopefully all the equipment that they need to have a really, really good session. So yeah, 16 people per class, and that includes the weekend classes, unfortunately. So we can't have those big boom and team mods for the foreseeable, but hopefully, you know, we can bring them back soon. So the next point on class bookings is that they will remain at 48 hours in advance. This has been really good in the outdoor sessions. Another period where class spaces are extremely limited. Usually everyone roughly knows what they're going to be doing in the following 48 hours, whereas we sometimes found in the old system, if you had 7 days to book in advance, you would almost reserve a space. Some, you know, it was possible you'd reserve a space rather than know that you were going to attend it, if that makes sense. So with our spaces extremely limited, the 48 hour in advance booking system works really well for us. But like all these measures, we're going to keep it under constant review. And yeah, if it needs to be moved, we'll look at that. Okay, point five, our class timetable will include 48 classes per week, and that's going to include a new 8 a.m. class weekdays. Okay, so it'll be the 6, the 7, and the 8 a.m. And that was a direct result of customer feedback in our last survey. People thinking that now with their new working situation, an 8 a.m. would be really useful. So we've got an 8, then we've got a 9:30. Then again, due to our restrictions imposed by government, we are going to close down after the 9:30. So at 10:30, that will be the 9:30 till 10:30 will be the last class, because every day we need to deep clean and sanitize the whole facility. Okay, and that does take a considerable amount of time and man hours, and we want to make sure that we're doing it properly. So during the day, during that period, we will not be open. Okay. Following on from there, it's going to be a 5:00, a 6:00, a 7:00, and an 8:00 class on a weekday evening, apart from a Friday, which will still be the 4:30, 5:30, 6:30. Okay. From there, at the weekends, we've got a 8:30, we've got a 9:30, 10:30, 11:00, and that's the same on a Sunday as well. Okay. So there are classes. Finally, in the email that was sent out, we've got a PDF document that details all the safe operational considerations we've got for you as a user to come into Method Training. So it details everything from our one-way system to how we're going to try and utilize the change rooms effectively, all the way through to just how to purchase a coffee on your way out for your way to work. So that's really important that you check that, and that's available to download in the email. So, as usual, any questions, make sure you get in touch with the contact us button. And you know, we're still trying to adapt as best we can to these restrictions. We're trying to make Method Training as good as it can possibly be with some pretty significant conditions imposed. We're also trying to make sure we have the best allocation of our staff. We don't want to burn our staff out, but we still want to provide the best service possible. So please just realize that what we have here isn't perfect, okay? And we're going to constantly try and adapt it to best suit everyone who's involved in the facility. But there will be some compromise along the way, and hopefully it's just going to get better and these restrictions will be repealed over time. But in the short term, these changes certainly are necessary. Okay, so looking forward to seeing you guys indoors soon.